Okay, so up on deck, we actually have Charlie, someone Rothmatics was speaking of about earlier, not too long ago, versus O-Nuts, rocking the can.
Now, Rothmatics, he's still here. Yeah. You said you lost to Charlie earlier, right?
I did.
So what's Charlie's history for those people? Does he come to Wednesday night fights all the time?
He does. Yeah, he's very consistent at Wednesday night fights. He shows up every week. He plays online a lot. Mm-hmm. He doesn't always get the best results, but I feel like that's kind of not necessarily from the lack of skill, but lack of confidence in himself.
Okay.
But he's turned it up today, definitely. He's playing really good.
Starting off with a nice V skill there to catch him from a full screen. Always trying to. One of the main goals of Nikali, of course, is trying to build up that V trigger
as soon as possible, right?
Yeah. So you can go into X Factor as soon as you can. So,
but O-Nuts is just going right in there with the EX Tatsu.
Unfortunately gets thrown back into the corner, and nice, good reaction with the anti-air, so Nuts not able to get out of the corner just yet.
Again. I like the awareness so far. Yeah, going in raw, but O-Nuts turning the tables around with a nice target combo.
You know what? I really like how well Charlie has been keeping him in the corner. He's tried to get out with like 7 different things already, and like none of them have worked, and Charlie has kept him in the corner the whole time, so.
Yeah. That's that Nikali pressure. He's definitely a really scary character if he can lock you down the corner.
Yeah, he's got a good anti-air stand light punch and a good anti-air uppercut, and you know, just a very strong all-around character.
Yeah, I mean, the one thing about this matchup from Ken's perspective is when he's not in full Super Saiyan mode, when he's not X-Factor,
right.
He can jump normal Tatsu, he can hit him with some jump pierces. If Nikali tries to anti-air with jab, that will get beaten out.
Right.
And his DP will also glyph if he does jump Tatsu. So there's some pretty strong jump mind games from the Ken player. But once he does get beat-triggered, this matchup totally changes. It's crazy. This dude becomes unleashed.
Whoa, the runs?
And from O, F, and Jeff?
Well, he's got the meter, so he's gone Saiyan now. So here we go.
Ooh. Bad DP. And he gets 3 of those.
And the nice thing about that is that side switch on it, so he gets to switch the corner position. Wow!
Catching him air to air with that.
Oh, yo, look at his face. He looks so perturbed. I see you.
Oh, with the.
He's got the hood up.
Yeah, do you see
he's ready.
He's the chosen one.
He's the chosen one.
This is like his movie right here. This is like the origin story. We're going to see him in Santa Monica for the finals.
He was the one who beat Cole early on stream.
That's
right.
Yeah. Okay. And he was laughing up a storm. Cole was not happy.
Yeah,
about
I know.
That. He went away super salty.
All right, roundhouse to roundhouse crush counter.
Getting in there runs?
With the run pressure.
Roundhouse.
Whoa, ooh, really? Okay.
I don't know. I feel like popping V-Trigger and then going into Super with Nikali is probably the way to go. Just because you get better OP, better corner pressure.
Yeah, you get more damage as well.
Exactly. Right, so.
But it looks like he's doing well right now. Gets the throw, and look at this pressure. Just still going in there. Wow, raw Tatsu punish.
Yo, I'm telling you, he is the chosen one. Only Dion could pull that off.
Oh, wow. If that air hurricane had connected, that could have been a problem. Might have been able to just combo right into super, but
this was really explosive, by the way. This was only game one. It was not explosive.
That's crazy. That is crazy. Yeah, Charlie clutches out that first round, though. He's looking around like, yo, did I do that?
He knows what he did.
He believes.
Fight.
Alright.
Well, Charlie used to have like one back ponytail. Did he cut that off?
Yeah, he did. Yeah.
Oh,
I don't know if he cut it off. I just can't see it, but I know he did have like that ponytail.
Yeah, man, he used to rock that.
Ooh, crush caps?
Uh-oh, that's punishable.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, wow, he just went for it.
I like how all three of us see it right here. We're all talking about it. It's like, oh, it's unsafe. Don't do that, man.
Oh, the wake-up stand jab. The Nikali standard. The classic.
3 frames, man.
Yep.
Why not do it, you know?
Exactly. Oh, again, that neutral jump in the corner for Charlie has been working well for him.
That was on reaction.
That had to be reaction. That was perfect timing.
Yeah, that's what looks like Nuts is thinking right now. He's like, man, he's like, really?
You got those?
Is that what we're calling him now? We're just calling him Nuts?
Yeah, that's what I call. That's what I've been calling him all day.
He's named after his playstyle, man.
Yeah, exactly.
Straight Nuts.
Just some straight nuts.
Cashew boys. Ooh, roundhouse.
Oh, the macadamia roundhouse.
Hit him with the hard almonds.
Hey, when his defense is strong, he's a walnut, right?
Oh, man, let's hope he doesn't crack.
This is too good. Oh, man. Oh, didn't get the juggle, unfortunately.
Hit him with the hard almonds. Roasted.
Oh, I like it. He had the pressure. He stopped the run pressure. Oh, he's going to be able to confirm. Yep.
Nice combo. Get some corner pressure. Ooh, whoa, that wake up jab?
Side switch coming.
He could have combo into super. He's a generous god.
One more hit away from victory is Charlie. Oh,
there it is.
There he goes.
Leaving nuts as salty as possible.
No, please. Jeremy,
this is
please.
Too easy.
No.
Dude, we are roasting him way too much right now.
You
could
say he got honey roasted.
This is way too good. This is cool.
But
shout out to Charlie. I can see why, you know, he is where he's at. Because he played very strong. Really good recognition throughout the match from full screen and the neutral in general. You know, that's awesome. Where Nicali wants to be,
right? Yeah,
by the way.
Yeah,
he wants to be up close and personal, but, you know, Charlie really took his sweet time and let Nuts approach him. So he made sure that he made the mistakes. And I know you like
it.
Dude, I was just waiting. I thought that smile on your face, I was waiting for another.
But I wasn't going to do it.
Okay, okay.
I wanted to conserve myself for the
other
matches.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I mean, like, does it, so as a competitor, obviously, does it make you feel good when you see the guy who beat you keep winning?
Absolutely.
Okay, okay.
Yeah. Uh-huh. If he beat me, he better win.
Yeah.
He has to win the whole thing by default.
Yeah, exactly. Because
he has the weight on his shoulders.
He
that
beat
is Rathmatics.
The best, you know? So if he beat the best, that means he's the best now.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
he's going to sweep this free. Like, no, okay. No challenge. Nobody's challenging.
There you go. Yeah,
well, he's looking like, he's looking like it right now, so.
Yeah.
Look at very strong. Shout out to him.
You know, Dion, Nuts. He messed up. He wasn't wearing these new Chun-Li shirts from Split Frame. Do you see these? Street Fighter perspective? Look at how clean this is.
You not know, as clean as that transition.
Yeah,
dude.
I know.
Let's talk about cleanliness.
Sejam has affected everybody.
Yeah, seriously.
Dude,
he felt it. Step my game
he felt
up.
It in his spine while he was out in Ohio.
Yeah, he's changed the whole world of
Segways.
Exactly.
Wherever you are, living your life. Yeah, but a friend of mine got that shirt. It's actually, I like the prints of it. It's like, it's very vibrant. I didn't expect it to be. Like, it really pops out.
Oh, that's awesome. That's good stuff. That's good stuff. Yeah, there you go. So, but yeah, so it looks like, oh, dang. Okay, it's another loser's match, but this one, wow. Who sent Filipino man to losers? Oh, that's right. That's right. That's right. Yeah, that's right.
I went to Starbucks to get one of those strawberry refreshers.
They're really good.
While that match happened. Yeah, I got
to record. Okay. I was like, okay.
But let's talk about Long real quick, or LPN. He got sent into losers by Romping.
Oh, my God.
Yep.
Another Ken player.
But see, the thing is, you know how you said you beat the best, you become the best, right? Well, remember during the Royal Rumble at CEO, LPN beat Justin.
Whoa.
And since Romfinite beat LPN, that now makes Romfinite the best player.
He's better than Justin Wong by association.
By the transitive properties.
I'm pretty sure that's how this thing works.
Yeah, exactly. But a loser's bracket match. Round LPN one. Going up against Filipino man.
Ooh, Alex versus Chun. You know, this match is typically really kind of tough for Alex to control the neutral against Chun. But I mean, you know, the nature of Alex is once he gets in, everyone's the same.
I feel like there's a you can't spell Filipino man without LPN joke somewhere, but I'm not sure how to make it work. So I'm just going to state it like that and we'll move on. Let's go.
I think that's all we need.
All right, he's going to go. Oh, he goes for the reset, but LPN has saw that against Brent is cool. Filipino man went for that reset a lot.
Interesting. Yeah, I know he definitely. The thing about Filipino man is he loves to play really fast, especially once he gets the offense going. But LPN, he's no stranger to good scrambles.
Yeah, especially with Alex. Alex with good buttons. Of course, Chun-Li has some of the best buttons in the game. Here we go. Gets the bird kick combo into the corner, but wake up!
Are you serious? Wake up, crap. That was like 5 frames.
That was crazy.
Not scared
at all. The belief, the heart.
Well, I mean, here's the one thing, though, is like a lot of people, I'm not even like. I don't feel like we've studied it down to a science enough that on all the knockdowns, if you dash up, are you plus or minus?
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, there's still a lot of situations where we're not sure. And if you do know and you see that happen, it's like free wake up jab every time.
Yeah, and I mean, it's also the mind game of people like to delay their buttons. So do you like delay jabs?
So right, right.
You try to delay your frame trap, but what ends up happening is you'll get caught with the wake up jab.
All right, so LBN going right back in there, but here we go. Probably no reset, misses it.
Nice
it's going
to
be safe, though,
Yeah, still keeps her safe, relatively safe, allowing her to continue this pressure here. Moving on from the neutral, nice cross under.
It's a common situation, but you know what? People still get. Oh, he went for the reset and stopped the combo again.
He got a little greedy. He might.
Oh, that could be it.
He's done.
EX backdrop 2 times. Oh, and a dropped combo is going to lose it for Filipino man. Those are the worst.
He had it twice.
Yeah.
He had 2 dropped opportunities to win.
While in V trigger, by the way, which extends like or adds additional hits, so it's really tough for
that to be dropped, and it's such a heartbreaker when it happens. I'm just saying, that's really tough.
Yeah. He should feel really bad. No, I'm just kidding. I'm kidding.
You heard it here first, man.
Man, Berserk at LPN with the elbows, pushing him to the corner. Look at that. It's not even 10 seconds in the match.
Yeah, right? I know.
Really good play for
him. Oh, the regular throws. Oh, he went for the overhead. Oh, and unfortunately, yeah, that forward dash is going to get him under that stomp. So now LPN in the corner position.
Yeah, really unfortunate that his offense kind of went awry, but good presence of mind for Filipino Man to dash under that stomp.
But the armor on the elbow slash, and this time it's the stun gun.
Go LPN.
Ooh.
You know, he lost some offense. He was like, you know what? I got to step it up. I'm the chosen Alex now. He's believing in everything he's doing. That's the one thing I love about watching LPN, is that he's very confident.
Oh, a little too close for that crouching medium punch, and it's going to get punished on block. So now LPN at match point.
Up against Filipino Man. Wow, this is much faster than I anticipated. Ow. Nice SPK, push him to the corner. Instant air legs.
Ooh,
get stung.
Oh, punish. Oh!
Should have gotten a little more off of that, but that's not a bad conversion whatsoever.
Look
stun
at this
gun, next
pressure.
Hit.
Oh, the overhead.
He's got
from
one
like
more
half a screen away.
Ooh, ooh.
That's a lot of damage here. Accumulating for up? LPN. One more ooh. Touch. Could have been it. The Filipino Man manages to escape, though.
And there it is. That's the counter it. Crouching light punch. Wow. Interrupting the offensive pressure from Filipino Man. Oh, and there it is, LPN.
Right when we say LPN. That, he just gets hit.
Yeah.
It's really unfortunate because he was starting to get his offense going. And then LPN just had that wall up enough to find that opportunity to knock Filipino Man out.
Well, that's one of those key situations, right? When an opponent like Filipino Man is needing to make that comeback and he gets the momentum going, a lot of times they start going in too hard, you know, and then you get hit by the, in Street Fighter 4, it's been the uppercut FADC, and this one, it's not, you just get hit by the jab, right?
So, pretty much.
But like, even in those situations where you recognize that you're in that desperation mode, like, I'm in there, I gotta do this now, you have to kind of dial it back a little bit sometimes, you know, because otherwise, the pressure will be too strong, and if you just walk into a jab like that.
So. Yeah, no, that's... Not a position you want to be in. But LPN, you know, the thing about that match, Alex versus Chun, is I think most people would say Chun wins that match, right?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
But if you play it in that style, you don't let Chun get in that situation where she's at advantage. It doesn't matter, you know? Alex gets in and he can start to run his gameplay.
I don't know. Looking at this monitor here, you know, one person has the word cool in their nickname, but only one of those guys up there is sitting there wearing shades.
Indoors?
Indoors with all that slick back hair, dude. Like,
oh, man.
He knows we're talking about him, too.
Romance is cool. I mean, let's face it here, you know.
He's got the crowd behind him also, it sounds like.
He's even got a tag with the game that's not even out yet.
Exclusive.
That's how cool he is.
Using the V-skill right away to go through the fireball and hit Ken at the same time. And I've noticed that about Brandon's cool. He always starts the round with like this very, very light fireball game and then like never goes back to it ever again.
That's really the Brandon special. Mind games.
Yeah.
Ooh, nice corner pressure from Romance. He went for a throw bait, but that's a forward dash back dash.
And I like that Romance got the throw in early, though, because it, you know, at least puts Brent to the point where he can get caught by shimmies now. Ooh!
That's a lot of damage.
Combos from Romance right now.
Empty! Wow, they're
neck and neck right now.
From that distance.
Oh! The surprise shoulder.
And Brent flinched. I don't know what he was looking for.
No, he's shaking his head back and forth like that shouldn't have happened.
Yeah. Watch.
I think he was going to go for an EX Tatsu possibly because he caught him midair.
That makes sense.
Okay.
Wow, really nice pressure from Romance.
Frame traps from Romance, and now that should be punishable.
Whoa, a little bit of mess up. He went for the instant Tenko and got throw.
Close for Dizzy, just wanted to touch him with that shoulder. Not quite. Ooh. Oh, okay. Caught him in the middle of that pressure string.
Brent slightly messed up his setup there. I think he was a little too close. Wow, nice conversion
that
on
so
that
top. Side swiped him. Just like.
Ooh, wow, the run pressure. No challenge from Romance.
Wow, using all of his meter
that
for
was
that.
Perfectly spaced.
Yeah, but unfortunately couldn't walk back. He saw him try to walk back so he wouldn't get crossed up so he can keep the corner position. Now Romance. Now back to neutral. Back to the middle of the stage.
Romance just activates the Grinkin. Brent's got to be careful. He's got a full stock super. That could be
it. Never mind. It ain't going to mean nothing.
Ooh.
Yeah, it's really unfortunate. Romance knows where he could have capitalized using all the meter to seal the deal, but didn't happen for him. Brent is cool.
driving and surviving.
Yeah, man. Even with no shades on indoors, he's still, you know, still
keeping
holding
it cool,
on.
Yeah.
Cool and composed.
All right.
Ooh, back strong.
Pressure, yep.
Hit confirmed. Yeah, this corner pressure is ridiculous. One more hit. Oh, nice.
Oh, that was supposed to be an air hurricane, maybe. Because that was a really early jumping medium kick.
That had to be.
I would imagine that was going to put out.
Good thing for... Oh, he went for the resets. Wow.
But Brent didn't really punish too heavily. Yeah. Romance is still in this. Two more touches and Brent could die.
Oh, he did it.
He went
for it. He needs to make the comeback, so he's going to go for the risk.
That's one oh-ho-ho quota.
Oh, wow.
But a little. He didn't believe in that.
Oh, no. Are you so many opportunities? Serious? Oh, he gets
no
the
way.
Okay, it's overhead.
It all hangs on this.
Oh, that's going to be punished.
Oh,
and
what? Oh, man. Romance clapping up a storm. You missed it, but Brent, not looking too cool over there. Chris Tarian, hand to his face.
No.
The KOF reactions from the teammates in the background is what it is. Yeah.
Oh. Did the stream catch the double clap pop-off from Romance?
No, they missed it. They missed it. Yeah,
that was ridiculous.
That was definitely two for the homies right there.
Yeah. Definitely looks like Chris back there. He's like, I do not approve my students.
Yeah. He looks like a super... He's standing over him like a concerned father.
Yeah,
okay.
No. Somebody's going to be banned from the dojo after this.
So he's kicked out the Trinity.
It's too much.
With that jump in.
Going to become the duo.
The dynamic duo.
No, please. The Wonder Twins.
Oh, yeah, there you go.
Back strong. Brent fighting back, though. He's no slouch. You know, he kind of... He would have won that last game. He definitely had the momentum, but there were some key mistakes that allowed Romance to clutch it, but his game plan wasn't necessarily incorrect.
Again, that's a second time now we've seen that. Brent is definitely getting baited very heavily by that shimmy now.
Yeah, man.
Such an extensive low forward, too. Being able to connect that into the palms, getting just enough of the super.
Ridiculous.
Really clutch stuff from Romance.
Yeah. There you can see Chris.
Right off the gate. That's two times that Romance has beaten the fireball right at the start of the round. And like I said, that's definitely something Brent likes to do at the start. And using the throw ender of
the Rasenha.
The Rasenha is just, you don't see that a lot.
Crush
ever.
Counter.
Yeah.
There's the cross up
top too. Online special.
The Manny, the CD Manny. Oh yeah, that's right.
Alright.
Corner pressure.
Oh, I thought he was going to do empty jump. Good block on Romance's part.
Nice reversal.
Yeah, I like that. Just get yourself out of that pressure situation.
Romance has got to be careful. A lot of gray health.
No uppercut. Okay, that time Brent didn't fall for it. You saw Romance did the shimmy again. Ran into the thunder kick.
Wow. Say get down.
That was a call out. He's like, I'm going to thunder kick from across the screen, and you're going to dash into it. Thank you. Thank you. Good confirm.
Miss a drop there.
Yeah, missed the V skill. That's unfortunate because not only do you miss out on the damage, but you miss out on the V trigger buildup. Oh no.
And Romance is looking really good.
That could have run into the super.
A little bit of a mess up there. Brent's still alive.
Yeah, but Brent needs to just get. Oh no, he spent some of the meter.
That's right. V trigger will make up for it.
That's a lot of damage with one bar.
And you're in the corner now.
Oh,
he's going to get hit. Yeah. But too far for a confirm, but look at this, Brent. This time he goes for the open G jump, yeah. I don't even know what I just said there. Open the G jump, yeah.
I'm a lot of syllables. In rapid succession.
Say, I know Chinese people are watching others, I'd be like, I was just speaking Chinese, you know.
There you go.
Yeah.
That's
good save. Good save.
But people at home are going to be like, don't even try, James. Don't even try.
Man, that was so hype. How can anyone concentrate?
Yeah, exactly.
Ooh, and did you notice with the clutch continuation from Romance? He just hit next while Brent was being coached. He said, you ain't coaching.
Oh, yeah. There it is.
Yeah.
You ain't taking
player one has the power.
Counter poke, crouch medium. Getting in there with that EX Tatsu and starting the run pressure now. Again, has that corner position. What's the mix of... Ooh!
He went for the shimmy slightly. He was just slightly too far.
Yeah. Ooh. Oh, wow.
Wow, that round was all Brent. You know, this has been pretty back and forth. Even if somebody got the lead initially, the other player would come back. But Brent was looking... He was looking cool and composed.
He was just all over Romance, whether it's in the corner or in the neutral space. Just commanding that
round. Crush counters whenever he wants them. make them all day.
Yeah.
I feel like crush countering.
You will give me crush countering.
Looks like Romance is going for throws now because he knows he's been successful with a couple of those shimmies. So now Romance has taken to the throw option. Oh, but he wasn't expecting the wake up uppercut. Nobody expects that to wake up.
Whoa.
It's because it's so crush counterable, you know, that it makes the wake up uppercuts better.
That should be the game.
So Brent is moving on.
That should be his new name, yeah.
Yeah.
Brent is moving on.
Dude, he stays in the Trinity.
Oh, yeah, that's right. He's not.
He earned his place. Congrats. Yo, good stuff, Brent.
But it's just, his membership has been renewed.
Yeah, dog.
It's just interesting because, you know, his name is Brent is cool, but he's using Ken as all this fire, you know.
Right. I was wondering when you were going to make that joke. It was just a matter of time.
We're all waiting.
Let it play out.
It's going to happen.
Yeah, Brent moves on over Romance. Again, if you guys want to tune in to, or if you guys want to check out the brackets, be sure to check it out at smash.gg/Vanguard to keep up with everything that's going on here. Top 16.
And if you feel like tweeting about the event, definitely use the hashtag RBVanguard to talk about it. So
yeah, Twitter boys.
Yeah, all your favorite moments, anything you want to correct us on or probably make fun of us.
Yep.
Whatever you guys feel like, hashtag RBVanguard.
Yeah, put the memes up there too.
Keep those coming. Right. Those are good stuff. Memes, the Wednesday Night Fight memes. Dude. Those things are epic, dude.
Yeah.
Like the greatest thing.
Those are one of my favorite parts of the show.
Yeah,
I know. Favorite.
I remember when I first fell in love with the Wednesday Night Fights memes is they made like a Mega Man boss. There was like a bunch of bosses. Yeah, and they had Jesse up there, Commander Jesse. He was Beard Man.
That was so sick.
I like that one.
That was great. Coming up. Okay, so this match, I'm actually pretty excited. It's Battle of the Romps. We got Rompinant versus Romp.
What? This is crazy.
Romp versus Romp.
I joked earlier that,
they're
fighting
for the name.
He went for that's Infinite Rom and that's Rom Finite, right? Yeah, right. So, you know, there you go. Yeah.
He's always been Rom. He's just kind of like, it's going to end eventually.
Yeah.
I'm going to cut you off here. It's a father and stepson moment is what it looks like.
Yeah, I know, right?
Stepson?
There's no way they look alike. I can't say father and son.
I respect that. I respect Rom.
Adoption, man.
That.
Adoption. Father and son. There you go.
Yeah.
All right, of course, Rom, as we mentioned earlier on stream.
That counter, he can
that was nasty.
Are you serious?
Right out the gate, Rom.
Now, that normally doesn't happen again. Rom got the counter hit with the low forward into the fierce. That was a chunk of damage.
Seriously.
Yeah, Rom, of course, as I mentioned earlier on stream, almost sending infiltration to loser's bracket at Evo.
That was ridiculous.
Yeah, came like surprised a lot of people.
Yeah, Rom is ridiculous. He's been ridiculous for a while. He didn't really shine too much in 4. I guess it wasn't really his game.
Yeah, he didn't play it much. Yeah,
he was stuck with Yang. Also, you know, he's a character loyalist.
Right.
In this game, you know, he's unleashed. Rom Finite.
Oh, here comes Rom Rompinit getting him in the corner. Almost dizzy, but what a whiff punish. And that's why that Rose is so useful, because
Absolutely.
It just confirms off of such far range moves with moves that you normally can't combo into anything.
Yeah, it definitely gives Vega a lot more
ground footsie threat. Like a threat.
Never mind what I was going to say. This is more exciting. Crush counter sweeps.
Rom, that was some slick stuff.
Rom.
That was so disrespectful. Rom.
Stop it, Rom.
This is not allowed to be broadcast right now.
Yo, thuggery.
We can't do this here.
The meaties.
You're not allowed. This is why he's part of the main four bosses in the Shadowloo.
Yeah, exactly.
That's exactly why he has a statue of himself.
Shadowloo Mount Rushmore.
That was disgusting.
That was
pretty nuts. That was pretty sick.
Honestly, after that, I think Rompinit, he should just take his disc, Street Fighter, just go to GameStop and turn that in. Like, honestly, I don't want to be seen playing that game.
A nice cool $3 credit.
Yeah,
and then they're going to sell it for $50.
Yeah, that moment was definitely worth at least $3.
Yeah. trying to get in there, but nice counter. Of course, it's not safe even on hit into any of the run cancels.
Yeah, no.
All right, going in. Still in the neutral space. Rom from it. Oh. Trying to find an answer, but Rom punishes him with a nice throw bait with punish.
Oh, what? Dude, that was dirty.
This dude, he's tool assisted. He is tool assisted.
I think he might be.
He has all the setups.
Yeah,
frame perfect. It's ridiculous.
And that's
the chosen one.
That's the tech right there. You know, when you go into the lab, this is the kind of things that you look for. You know, you look for these proper meaty situations and how to react to them all. And now you can record the opponent to react in like 7 different ways, you know. So it's really, really useful. You can tell Rom has definitely put in the time. Oh, I love that. Dashing all the way up to punish the neutral jump.
roundhouses in the corner. Wow, and a side switch. See, Rafinek got a little greedy there. He was feeling his momentum, and he jumped and put himself in the corner.
Yeah.
Especially against Vega, you never really want to. You don't want to do that. You know, screen positioning is huge in this matchup.
Remember.
Ooh, okay, okay.
That's how it feels today. Top two Saturdays.
What?
Top two Saturdays. You were lying.
Oh, empty jumping. Wow, Rafinek.
Some dirty stuff of his own. Rafinek showing he's not just some young buck.
Final
he's got those tricks, man. Rom got shaken up a little bit.
Yeah. Something turned on all of a sudden. Rafinek.
I think Rafinek came over and punched him in the face. That's what that was. He's shaking himself like he got hit in the jaw.
Oh, had to shake that one off real quick.
Okay. Oh, wow.
Whoa.
Both of them dashed forward.
Yeah. It was a little like scrambly.
Oh, yeah, good block.
That's punishable.
Oh, sweep.
But only a stand jab, so not much off of that. All right, now Rafinek now with 1 meter, so his jumps become a lot more dangerous. Ooh, okay. Mom's going to hold on to that meter. Didn't spend it for anything. Oh, but that was also claw mode crouch strong, so he can't cancel it.
That's right. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Ooh, catch this fierce.
The runs. Rafinek with no fear in his heart.
Uh-oh, and there it is. You saw it go for that same situation. Cross up and cornered himself.
Ooh.
Okay, fear. Not going to save his meter for the trigger.
Anti-air rose.
Is that going to kill? There's going to be no scaling on the super. Almost.
Close,
almost.
Close.
I sense an overhead. I think it's going to happen.
Nope, doesn't matter. Hey. No TP's
well,
there.
You know
I think
what?
That was a safe jump.
It's
fine. The, jumping,
certain,
the jump kick
yeah,
is an overhead, right?
Yeah, oh, that's true. Yeah, yeah, you
so you were right.
Okay.
I'm half right. I'll take
yeah.
that.
Yeah.
Okay. As long as I'm somewhat right. But
now remember, Rafinek was the one that sent LPN to losers. So Rom there getting a little bit of revenge for his NorCal brethren.
That's right.
He's like, you're not sending all of us to losers.
Yeah, the story building is too intense right now. It's NorCal versus SoCal.
Seriously.
A bit of Arizona, but it's okay.
Yeah, but Arizona doesn't—they don't count. It's just about soaking.
Okay,
exactly.
All right. Dude, I've been dogging on Arizona all day, so you know, it doesn't matter. I might as well keep going. They hate me already.
You know,
so,
just you can't go halfsies. You got to go full on.
Exactly.
You know,
exactly.
Just
it's like playing
Arizona.
Footsies. It's like playing footsies,
yeah,
right?
You
can't
believe.
Go in half. You know, halfway. So.
You got to dedicate. Yeah, that's right. You got to commit. Speaking of commit, be sure to, you know, hit up James Chen on his Twitter. Let him know how you really feel about all that. All the people from Arizona that might possibly be tuning in.
Ooh, yeah, you know, they got it. Here's the thing. They sent over the spies. You know, they sent over Driftwood and Velociraptor from Arizona.
Yeah.
I think there might have been a couple of others. But
well,
you know.
Yusuf was playing earlier at Wednesday.
Yeah, Yusuf has been showing up quite often. Yeah, every week.
Yusuf is ridiculous. That
he's
super good. Yeah.
It's unfortunate he's not here today. He would have been possibly top 8 candidate.
Yeah, I know.
With the way
sure.
he's been playing.
Yeah, he's a really solid player.
You guys were talking about Daily Tane a little bit.
Yes,
earlier.
Daily Tane, best bird.
Remember, you were saying you were like trying to pick who would win this. You said Chris Tatarian was kind of the favorite, but you said maybe Daily Tane. Hey,
look
guess what?
Daily Tane.
Guess what? You were setting up this match. You saw the brackets earlier, right? Good job.
Ooh,
good job.
You know, I had to hype it up for the people.
Yeah, exactly.
So smart.
Yeah, I actually forgot that they were playing when I said that, but I actually knew that beforehand. Daily Tane is ridiculous. I'm just going to throw this out here.
Okay.
He's one of those players that was getting comfortable with fighting games in Street Fighter V.
Mm-hmm.
He's been showing up to win some fights consistently, and then he went to EVO and he got 33rd. You know, he
that's remarkable, by the way.
He took out a lot of people. Yeah, it wasn't like an easy 33rd.
What did they say? He was like the third highest SoCal member out of everyone, right? The first was Ken Pope.
Yeah,
right.
Hugo 101.
Right. Yeah, but apparently he wants to just only be known as Kenneth Pope.
Kenneth
now,
Pope. He's
so
rebranding.
Yeah.
You know, hey, it's the age of sponsorship.
Yeah, but no one
can
ever get their nickname changed. Like, it just doesn't happen.
It's unfortunate, but yeah,
his
that's
name's
how it
got
is.
Numbers in it. You know, you got to, at
mean,
that point, you got to rebrand.
Some
know?
People try it. Like,
numbers?
They change their name to Hype Fiend, and it's like, come
ooh,
on.
Baby.
You know? But you know, so.
RIP.
But yeah, Ken Pope was like the highest, and but yeah, to be the third highest is really impressive in that kind of a pool of 5,000 players.
Yeah,
and he came out of nowhere. For like people that have been tuning into the FGC events, he literally came out of nowhere. He's literally had his grounding here at Wednesday Night Fights in SoCal, and that's pretty much it. I don't really see him at majors or placing or even going to those majors. And then here
he
is at EVO. I came to play and I got 33.
And even a lot of the Wednesday Night Fights that I don't go to, you know, I watch it a lot of the times. I don't even remember seeing Daily Tane on stream that often.
That's the thing.
You know,
he's one of these under-the-radar players. His matches don't really get streamed too much. He's I don't want to say inconsistent, but he has moments of greatness, and I'm hoping to see it right here.
Well, hopefully that changes. If he does really well at this tournament, you know, he's going to be one of those guys that they're going to try to put on stream all the time at Wednesday Night Fights.
Absolutely.
But Chris, wow, he's like, I don't care about you, Daily Tan. Look, this is, I'm going to show you how up and coming you are, you know?
He's got to go through the proving ground.
Ooh, okay.
Now, Daily Tan has been utilizing that a lot while he's been playing. He's using that armor to get through most of your pressure when there's a considerable gaps. That's really strong for him to recognize that.
Just like that. Look at that. He's tied up the life.
Activates the V-Trigger. Wants to get the increased move speed and extra damage on command throws. Corner pressure on Chris Tartarian. This could be really tough for Birdie. Ooh. I mean, the thing about this match is Birdie can generally control the neutral. But once Ken gets in,
that empty
really
jump
hard.
Not quite dead yet though, so hey. Still an opportunity for Daily Tan. He just
Whoa,
needs
Chris
one good sequence.
Though.
Oh, but he was waiting for that jump. Daily Tan went for like three jumps at the end, and finally at the end, Chris was like, "You know what? I'll let you jump, and I'll get my uppercut."
He had the answer.
Oh man, look at the range on that.
Wow! Great use of that armor. We were talking about that earlier. Crush counter combos.
That's a lot of damage.
He gets a nice setup after that.
Ow! You alright? You alright back there?
Yeah. Yeah.
I want to make sure you're alright, man. That sounded like that's a little painful.
Ooh. Protest. See, and just like that, now Chris has
The shimmy. Gonna get him.
Can only go
down
there.
Ooh, wow.
Great overhead fake in the low, but even better block from Daily Tan.
Oh, no, but that's still going to get stunned. Yeah.
He tried to go for a crouch strong there. You can see a little head bob, but Chris Tartarian is going to take it.
Not quite.
One more.
Max damage conversion off that EX fireball. Daily Tan can still win this.
Absolutely.
Oh, yeah. He's got a lot of meter.
V reversal from Chris. Whoa. Defensive bar.
Okay, I like that V reversal. Just kill the pressure.
Oh, he got it.
Okay, one more EX headbutt and he wins.
Yeah. Ooh, that could have been it. Daily McTainerson, come on.
I was clenching it out a little bit.
Yeah, that was
we called EX headbutt or EX command grab and that could have happened.
Yeah.
It would have worked.
No, Chris backdashed right there. Chris backdashed. That was smart recognition from Chris. Daily Tan, he wanted to watch. I think he might have been expecting a charge. But Chris, one step ahead.
Chris using that, like you were saying, Jeremy, like really good use of that in the middle of pressure situations.
Ooh.
Again, see right there.
Just working out for him.
See, now that is unsafe on block. Chris can punish with a medium kick in a roundhouse. He doesn't have to go straight DP. But just to be safe, goes for the easy punish. Smart.
Okay, see, there's one of those situations. Might as well uppercut if you're trying to block it.
You gotta be careful now. Daily Tan does have V-Trigger. Went for the anti-air, but EX got
What side? Oh, good read, but then just that stuff.
Yeah, you know, Ken don't wear no shoes, too, so he hits him with the toes with that medium kick around.
That's a spicy toe, man.
Spicy toe,
dude,
man.
I'm telling you, he's definitely got some of that. He hasn't been using any of that antifungal cream.
Nah, man,
it just burns automatically. Yeah, as he senses it, just turns it on.
Just
like
wants to make it as grotesque as possible when he kicks you in the face.
Yeah, that's extra damage right there. That's tournament stress. You show
it's
up with
it's
no
lingering
deodorant.
Damage once he cuts you.
Yeah, exactly.
Instant infection. Gross.
Bonk. Damage over time.
Oh, no, not ready for that run cancel. If you just throw it out there every once in a while, it's just it's tiring. Your brain gets tired always worrying about it, you know, so you're just going to get caught by it every once in a while. Oh, great block on that empty jump.
Ooh, goes to the forward fierce. No punish from Chris, though. Could have been much worse for Daily Tan.
Might have just been at a range and he wasn't confident about it, but here we go.
Doesn't die? Ooh, goes immediately for that EX full head.
Oh, no, no V reversal this time.
Yep.
That's gonna do it.
Chris Tartarian flushes it out over Daily Tan.
That was a
really
sick
dominant.
Confirm, by the way.
Yeah, seriously. There, you know, there's a pseudo option select where you can throw that fireball and just buffer the V trigger. If the fireball hits or is blocked, then you go into V trigger. And if not, if it travels for a distance, then nothing happens.
Right.
Really good stuff from Chris, man. That dude's ridiculous.
Oh, and we got another one of the Birdie Bros. We got Futile.
Futile going
nice.
Up against Roman.
Okay. Futile, I
believe. Futile.
Futile
boy.
Futile.
Futile boy.
Futile. Futile.
Futile.
Something like that. Yeah. Futile up on deck right now for the stream. I believe he plays Laura. He's also coming from Birdie.
Yeah.
But originally he was an able main in Street Fighter 4.
That is true.
He was trying to find a character that he could replicate his playstyle in.
Mm-hmm,
and it wasn't working too well with Birdie, so he found Laura to be that kind of
I guess. More of an aggressive kind of game. Right. You know, like when Abel gets the step kick and he's in your face. Right. Like, I feel like that's what he's looking for more of. And, you know, I talked to him. I actually think that even if Laura doesn't turn out to be the character that he sticks with, having played a lot of Laura is going to make his birdie better as well. Just, I mean, like, I used to only use Street Fighter 4 Cammy, right? So, like, that was the only character I played for a really long time. Then I started experimenting with some other characters. And then it made me realize just how good and broken Cammy's jump roundhouse was, because none of the other characters had anything like that was even close to being that good. And it's like, so when you use the different characters and you know, you experiment a little bit, you start learning what makes your character good. And so it's easy to break away from certain habits and makes you really learn how to take advantage of some of the things that you have.
That's true.
Yeah. So I always recommend, like, every once in a while, just like, you know, just don't worry about your points online. Play some random select characters. Just go there and experiment. Find out how those characters function, and you'll be strong against those characters afterwards. And it'll make your main better as well.
So we're going to have Futile versus Romance. Now, I couldn't even recognize him without his sunglasses on.
Let's see how much of a change
that is for him. That's this time around.
He looks much sadder without his
That's just his game face. Yeah. Super concentrated.
He went from cool to depressed in a quick minute. But man, did you see that Rasenha from a full screen to punish Laura fireballs?
Yeah, you know, it's very hard for Laura to get away with throwing fireballs. On reaction, Karen can V-skill, and that will eat the fireball and hit Laura. Mm-hmm. She can also do a Rasenha over the fireball. So it's risky from Laura to throw that in mid-screen. Yeah, I played this matchup a little bit with Futile. He's definitely getting more comfortable with Laura as a character.
Yeah. I mean, I would imagine so. He's obviously made it very far here in this tournament. This is top 16. Oh, wow.
Wow. Goes for the EX Bolt. A little bit of belief there. Doesn't connect, but he doesn't get punished for it.
Yeah, well, right now, Romance has just been doing a great job just not giving Futile any sort of momentum. Futile really hasn't. That's how Laura plays. She gets you the knockdown, and then she goes in. And we just have not been able to see that from Futile yet at all.
Sadly.
And with Romance doing a great job in the neutral space, using all her max range normals to keep Laura at bay, just like that, stopping her dead hair tracks, and that's what makes it, I feel, more of an advantage for Karin versus Laura in this matchup.
Yeah, Laura's not really well known. Outside of that standing roundhouse, which you see Futile use all the time, she doesn't have a lot of great footsie buttons, you know?
Yeah.
Kind of a more short-ranged buttons.
Definitely. I mean, they can counter poke, right? Like her crouch strong.
Right.
But in terms of establishing offensive pressure.
The roll button. Oh, yeah, that was nice.
Yeah. I gotta watch this match. Ooh. Goes for the roundhouse. No crush counter. That fireball was out there for longer than I expected.
Oh, and I love him countering that.
Goes to the plus frames. No, Futile challenging.
Oh, and then overhead. Oh, but no, didn't link off the overhead. I don't think he thought it was going to hit. Oh, he did it again. He did it again.
Oh.
He just went for it.
I don't understand why Futile, the first time around, he stopped the Rekka's dead in its tracks.
Yep.
Right.
The reversal.
Yeah, completely. Well, he used jab also. Jab countered it to stand strong.
Yeah.
And then this time around, Romance did it three to four more times and got away with murder. And then I don't, you know, it's something you got to keep in mind.
Yeah.
I think a lot of people are kind of hesitant to spend their V gauge on V reversaling Karen's Rekka's, but I feel like it makes everything easier. You don't have to deal with that guessing game. You know, should I crouch jab? Should I block? Is it going to go overhead? Is it going to go for the grab? Is it going to go, you know, backdash? You don't have to worry about any of that if you V reversal those first two hits.
Yeah.
And I would like to see Futile make that adjustment, because it kind of stops Romance from running that set play. Mm. So he's taking some time. You know, he's thinking about his decision. He's sticking with Laura.
He's not switching out
to the Birdman.
I think the Birdman still kind of excels a little bit more than Laura would in this matchup.
Well, I mean, I know a lot of Karen players used to hear them say that they felt like Birdie was like one of Karen's bad matchups.
Mm. I definitely think Birdie has an advantage over Karen. It's of course not unwinnable.
But the other thing too, though, is if Futile is trying to learn this character, sometimes you have to take your sour grapes. You know, you gotta take the.
You gotta go through these matches. You know, when you're not sure, man, should I run it? If you want to really dedicate yourself and you want to get better with your character, you have to stick it through.
Like we see Ricky Ortiz do that all the time. She always goes to tournaments and like she's trying to learn Nash, and she will play Nash the whole tournament, even if it made it better for her to switch to Chun-Li.
Yeah.
Like she won't do it. So, and that's smart. It's absolutely a smart thing to do.
It's how you learn.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
especially in the tournament environment. You know?
Yep.
Oh, man, just caught it right out of the dash. And Romance is just going nuts now.
Yeah, they dropped the counter hit combo. Really unfortunate, because now Futile's about to get started, pushing Romance into the corner little by little, but this V reversal keeping her in check.
Futile has not gone for a lot of command throw setups yet.
No, not at all. He's definitely been playing very conservative. He doesn't want to take any huge risks.
Yeah.
Kind of just keeping consistent pressure.
I think.
You can confirm it. That's it. Romance takes it over Futile.
Yeah, I think it was really honestly one of those situations where Futile was respecting Romance a little too much.
Yeah.
A lot of the times you can second guess yourself and cause problems in that situation. And most of the time when you see, like, I don't know if you would consider Futile beating Romance an upset necessarily, but most of the time upsets happen is when the person who isn't, quote, supposed to win disrespects the opponent and just treats them like anybody else. You know, that's usually how it works.
That makes sense. Yeah, man. I mean, good stuff to Romance. He was definitely, he played really, the gambles that he took, he played a little crazy, right? But it was a smart crazy.
Yeah, that was a lot more towards the end of the set, because in the beginning you saw him playing fundamentally sound with Karin, really utilizing those normals again, maximum range, keeping Futile out, which is where Laura really shines as a character. That close quarters combat is a huge threat with Laura, because again, she has a command grab, which Futile didn't really get to use.
Yeah.
Really decent mix-ups off of using the meter from the thunderclap, knocking the opponent to the air, and you get that 50-50 side switch possibility. So again, it's something we really wanted to see Futile kind of use during the set, but unfortunately it didn't play out that way, and that's just how it goes in high-pressure situations or high-profile events.
Yeah, man.
Romance is also just super good player, and it's really refreshing to see, too, because, you know, obviously he was one of the best in King of Fighters, right?
Yeah, for sure.
I remember when he first tried to learn Street Fighter 4, it was really, like, the concept of the game, the way the game flows was very different from KOF, and he really seemed like a fish out of water. I remember very early on, like, playing with him a little bit, and he was just, like, you know, kind of trying to grasp it, and now here he is in Street Fighter V, and he's just, like, dominating everybody, so, you know.
Definitely one of the best Karens in California.
Absolutely. Romance is ridiculous.
Of course, other than Justin Wong. You know.
Of course. No, there's some good ones, and you know.
There's you, right?
Yeah, Rathmatics is what you're talking about.
Oh, right, yeah. Exactly.
Man, so this is the run back. Romfinit sent LPN into losers, but LPN was running Alex.
Yeah, Rom set that whole thing up for LPN, is what it was. Yeah.
That must have been. NorCal boys, you know, the brethren.
Oh, the neutral jump, and he's going to get full confirm off of that.
There's something about playing birdie that makes you want to tech throws, man. I don't know what it is. It's some sort of magical force. You pick that character, you see people neutral jump.
Oh, there's that cam set up. Oh,
that was
at that time.
Beautiful.
Yeah, we saw that work earlier on stream, but no.
Not
I think Romfinit has seen it. Oh! No uppercuts!
Oh. He just looked at him.
Whoa. He watched them up all the way just to watch them come back down. Really unfortunate.
Yeah. LPN, he was playing a little crazy, but it paid off for him right there.
Oh, okay, trade. Very fortunate for LPN, because, I mean, even though he gets knocked down, he can do so much damage off of that EX Hurricane if it lands.
Oh, sit down! Overhead from that far?
The new ads here. It's the meta.
It's the new meta.
The meta has been advanced. Somebody get on SRK. We gotta post that in the Discord.
Requires some massive psychicness, but you know.
That was so sick.
That was really good. I like that. I thoroughly enjoyed that.
Oh, punish? Ooh, but he dashed up and he hurt his chances, but now it gets the throw into the corner. Here comes that Ken corner pressure.
Oh, what? We don't need hit confirms.
Oh no, missed the air hurricane. Yeah,
for sure. See, man, playing birdie just makes you want to throw tech. Doesn't make sense.
Full screen.
Yeah. You know, that might have been a bait, because his throw tech looks a little bit like his heat animation. That would be really smart for him.
Oh, that's it.
Big damage.
All right, so LPN says, look, this is not happening again. And you know what? I mean, honestly, we talk about this all the time in tournaments. Whenever you get that run back, when you lose a match, you think about it all the time. You're like, I should have did this. Oh, I should have. When you win, you're like, yeah, I won. And then you walk away, right? Yeah. And so, you know, LPN was thinking about it like, oh, I probably should have went to birdie. I could have done this and did this.
Yeah.
And now he's like, oh, well, here's that opportunity. Let me do that. And so run back is always really hard to win a lot of times.
It's tough, man. It's tough. I know.
That was sick. He tried to make himself safe, but not quite. Rockman being able to punish that. That was a really inventive kind of situation.
Yeah, seriously. A bit of a scramble.
Ooh.
taking a page out of Daily Tane's book.
Yeah, man, he peeped those matches. Wow, double V reversal? Ronfin said no. This is going to go for the Z Nice. He attempts the Z Nice, but Ronfin smartly back techs that.
Whoa, the can!
Yo, the can still a factor. V reversals again. Pushing him to the corner. V reversal again.
Ooh.
What? That bullhead made no sense.
Wow, that pressure. Just dashing up and poking a lot. Just waiting till he broke. Waiting till that defense broke.
Yeah, LPN's fighting like a wild animal right now.
Whoa, do you see? Just standing in neutral?
Footsie master.
That is some disrespect. Yeah. Showing I am not scared of you at all. Ooh, could be chasing that with the fireball.
Going off screen with that EX bullhead. Nice fireball pressure.
Hold that overhead again.
Ronfin is not scared at all to close the space. Catches that fierce. Look at the damage here.
Push him to the corner.
Such a satisfying corner carry.
Yeah,
blocking that. Dude, the Roundhouse Hurricane is like the coolest it's ever been, like in any time Ken has ever appeared in a fighting game. Like,
for sure.
It just looks so sick.
Yeah.
Like, I thought it was sick in Marvel when he went up, but now he like goes up and down.
That's,
so,
that's the business right
there. Yeah. Oh no, that's death. That's definitely not the business.
That was 2-0.
Right there. LPN taking it in such a convincing fashion. I think, you know, going into birdie right out the gate is what the key was to victory for LPN.
Yeah, that was definitely the key change there. That was a huge difference in terms
major key alert is what that was.
Major,
definitely.
Yeah, not low key. Not low key at all. Major key.
Major key.
Major
key. Stuff to.
That's the new.
Not a minor key.
No. Major key.
Major key. Okay.
It's like C. You know, C like the bait C major.
Went right over both of your guys' heads. I think. I don't know. I'm not gonna go.
Did it? I think it did. Man. Wait, all right.
Okay. Anyway, yeah. I'll hit you with another one in a bit. Okay.
But
coming up next, we have. It looks like. Coming up is Mr. Player. Going. Right. Is.
Driftwood the run back.
Wait.
Oh, this is a right. Okay.
Yeah.
Before we get into that, we're actually going to take a quick commercial break.
Oh, okay.
We're going to get into top 8 in just a minute. So, guys, just stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Yeah. Fight.